Good morning once again. So in the previous class, we have started discussing the shell scripts and we discussed some of the example. Whether my voice is audible? Whether my voice is audible? Okay. In the previous class, we were discussing about the shell script. Say the shell script, the reason behind the shell script is the group of commands you have to execute in a single stretch. That is why the shell programming is required. In the example which I am showing now, there are 6 to 7 commands are there. All the 6 commands, if I want to execute, 6 times I have to run in the interpreter in the command line. Instead of that, all the commands I'm going to write it in a single file and I'm going to execute that. This entire the group of commands, if you write it in a single file and if you give some name, some file name .sh, then it is called as a shell script. We don't use the word program. Here we use the word shell script, which contains multiple commands. This program, what you are seeing, it is first line, which is an interpreter line, which tells about the which shell which is going to run, which always starts with ash exclamatory mark, the address of the shell you are going to give. Other than this line, if any line, if it starts with hash means, then it will be treated as a comment. It will be ignored by the shell. This is an echo command. Echo command. If you want to include the commands inside the statements, echo statements. See, if you want to include the commands, you have to use this back quote. If you use this back quote, then this date, see the difference between this date and this date. It is a normal text date. But the date which is inside the back quote, that will be treated as a command. That is why it is going to display the today's date, month, and this is a dollar shell, which is an environment variable. Inbuilt variable. That inbuilt variable, it is going to display the content of that shell. And this is what we discussed. If executable permission is not there, if the executable permission is not there, you can give the executable permission with the chmod plus x. Chmod plus x, if you give, it will give you the executable permission for that file. In order to run the script, it is sh followed by file name. The file name extension is sh. Yeah, it is not always mandatory, but better practice is you have to use it. How to make the shell script interactive? We make the interactive by including the read statements in between the script, in between the commands. Instead of hard coding the values inside the program, we take the input from the user. The input from the user is stored in so many variables. In this case, enter the pattern to be searched. After that, read pname. Whatever the user enters, that will be stored in the pname. In the same way, read fname means whatever the user enters, it will be stored in the fname. If you want to print that values, you have in the echo statement, you have to use $pname, $fname. If you want to include that in the command, grep $pname, $fname. You have to use this dollar with the variable name, then only you will get the content of that variable. This is how you are going to make interactive. It is not only a single variable you can give. You can give multiple names. That is what I am going to demonstrated. Next was the command line arguments. See, this command line arguments is, as I said, the input you can directly give whenever you execute itself. Whenever you execute the program, there itself you can give the input. They are called as then command line arguments. for each input what we give in the command lines, there will be a specific number for that. That is why it is called as positional parameters. Positional parameters. Here there are so many parameters are there. There is a special importance for each parameter. This dollar hash, if you include it in a shell script, that will give you the count. How many arguments that you have passed in the command line. Dollar zero, if you give the name of the file you have executed. Dollar one means first argument. Dollar two, second, third, fourth. In that way, it is going to print. The dollar star and dollar at will give you the complete set of inputs. Complete, if you have given five inputs, all the five inputs, it will be stored in a single variable. You can directly print. Now, this has a more importance now. Dollar question mark. If you have executed a command, whether the output is positive or whether it has a failure, if you want to check the exit status of the last command, dollar question mark, if you print, you are going to directly get it. The current shell process ID, if you want dollar dollar, dollar exclamatory mark, if you give the last background job which is going to running, that process ID you are going to get. These many parameters we use multiple times. Look into this. This example we have seen in the previous class. Now we will start with the exit command. See, this exit command is exit and exit status. Every program is going to end with success or with the failure. Every command is going to end with the success or the failure. But we want to check that whether it is a success or a failure. Where it is required, we have written a very big application, a very big software. In that software, in middle of the software, we have written a logic in this way. We're going to search for the file. If that file is not found in one particular location, you want to search in another location. If you don't get there, one more location. If the user doesn't enter something, some message you have to throw to the user. In this way, the logic is in that software. If you want to do that, you want to check the output of the previous command. Where exactly it is stored? There is an exit function or the statement will be there. Every time that way, the exit status will be returned to that command. If you directly print that, you are going to get it. Exit status will be returned to the calling command. Exit status will be returned to the calling command. If it exits successfully, the exit status will be true. If it fails, the exit status will be false. If you see the number zero, it indicates that the previous command, it has executed fine. One means something went wrong there. We'll see with the example, then it will be clear. See, I'll open the terminal and I'll go to the folder cddirocd. Now, here there is I'll open the grep command, and there is one file. This is the pattern I'm going to search, echo, in the file called sampleshell.sh. If I enter, wherever echo is there in that particular file, it will print all those lines. Four lines echo statement is there. That is why it is going to print. Whether it has executed successfully or not, how to check? Echo dollar question mark indicates zero. Here it gives zero. Zero indicates Everything went fine. It has found. See now, I'll open the file cat sample shell. See, in this program, nowhere hand or any other word, example, one bush. There is no word called bush. Now, I'll search the word bush. B-U-S-H, bush, inside that file. Whether I get, no, that file is not there. What is the status of the previous command? See, echo dollar question mark, here it indicates one. Means it is a failure. You don't get that pattern. This dollar question mark, it will be automatically be set by the grep command. Once the execution of the command is over, the dollar question mark will be automatically, it will be set. If it gives the output, if it finds the output, then the output will be zero. Or else the output will be one. The doubt arises here is, if the command name is wrong, here the pattern was wrong. If the pattern was not there, if the file name is not there, if the file name is not there, what is the exit status? See, $2. This is a totally different error. This is totally a different error. The numbers what you see, it is not always 0, 1. For each number, it has its importance. I'll show another number. If the command is wrong, pattern is correct, pattern is, echo is there, file name is there, but now the command is wrong. In that case, what is the status if you check? The error name is 127. It has its importance, the error name, which indicates that command itself is wrong. But here, you please look into these two numbers, 0 and 1. This 0 indicates it has given you the output. And 1 means something went wrong. It is not given you the output. Means something went wrong, something is not there. That is what the meaning. That is what about the exit status. This is exit status. It is mandatorily, it is required whenever you develop any application. Without this status of an command, the exit status of the commands, you cannot write an application itself. Any software you write, this is the main requirement, because the next logic will depend upon the output of the previous command. If you don't know the status of the previous command, how will you continue the development of the application? Means how it will work. That is why this is the main requirement, exit status of any command. For that reason, with that number 0 or 1, you can proceed. If 0 is the case, okay, continue the execution. If the number is 1, something went wrong, go to a different location, or the logic will change. The next we'll go to the operators. In the C language, whatever you have seen the operators, the same operators, some of the operators you are going to see, looping statements, the AND, OR, then if statements, while loops, case. These are the things we are going to discuss now. Here now, you will discuss some two operators. And also after that, conditional execution, if statement, ampersand, and pipes, two pipe symbols, or what this indicates, it is going to return true if it executes both, or else, or means if one is executed, that is enough. If one executes, that is enough. We'll check now. There is a file called EMP list. Whether that file is there? EMP list is there. What it contains? Cat EMP dot list. Okay. So many names are there. In that directory is also there. Okay. Now I'm going to search Now I'll search, see, grep command. I'm searching the word director in the file employee.list, ampersand pattern found. Why that file is not there? Okay, I should go to that particular directory. CD DIR OCT. See what happens? It has given you the output of the first command. Wherever the director is there, wherever the director is there, it has brought those lines. And also it is going to print the message pattern found. It is going to print the second command pattern found. Now I'll give another name, director 123. Now if you check, it is not going to give you the output because it has not found this pattern inside the file. Then why it is going to print this pattern found? It will not go to this statement itself, second statement. If it works properly, then it will go into try to execute this. If it doesn't give an output, if it is a false, if the return value of the exit status is 1, then it will not go to the second pattern or the second command. This is AND operator. The same thing now I'll change to OR. See now, director 123, that pattern, it is not there in that AMP.LST. If you use the AND operator, it fails in the first command. That is why it will not go to the second. But if you use the OR, see, it is found failure in the first one. That is why it is going to go to the second command and it is going to print pattern found. I'll show the another case. The file director, it is there in the EMP list. And if I press enter now, pattern found message is not going to print. See, pattern found is not going to print because this command execution is successful. It is enough. Or symbol, if this is found, it is enough. It will not go to the second one. If it fails, then it will go to the execution of the second one. But that is not the case with the AND. Both the commands should be proper. See, I'll do one more thing. The first command works properly, but the next command, the echo command, I'll do some mistake. The directory is found in the emp.list, But the second command, it is showing you some error, because this is not a proper command itself. That is why it will show the output of that also. If you have given the one more grep command, I'll do that also, and we'll try grep director. We'll include two grep commands. Here, what happened is AND operator, it has executed first, it has given you the output, then it is going to try to bring the output of this, but this director is not there, that is why director 1 is not there, that is why it is not going to print. If I enter both two times grep command, once again this grep command AND operation, two times it is going to print. The first half is the output of the first command, the next half is the output of the second command. This is how the AND operator and the OR operator is going to work. That is what we have used the example. In the same way, you can use the positional parameters. Positional parameters $1 and 2 means whenever you give the input itself, there only you can, those values that will be stored in these variables, directly you can use that with these operators. That is the meaning of these two logical operators, AND OR. Next, we'll come to the if statements. See, the shell programming or the shell scripts, we say, whenever we say shell script, there will be a logic. If one command execution is successful, okay, execute some set of statements. If that fails, let's go to the another set of statements. If that fails, we'll go to the another set of commands. In that way, the logic will be maximum times, 99.99 times, the logic will be like this itself. In order to execute those two-way decisions, three-way, four-way decisions, we have to use this if statements. Without the if statements, it is not at all possible to write the any type of program where there is a decision-based logic. Without the decision means it is not at all required. If there is a decision statement, then if statements are required, mandatory. This you already know. If a command is successful, if the command is successful, those who have not sent the attendance, please send. If the command is successful, then execute this set of statements. How to end? You have to write once again FI. At that indicates that if is been closed. If command is successful, I think many of you have sent the attendance in the beginning itself. Don't send once again. If you have not sent, you can send now. Okay. If that command is not successful, then it will go to the else execute set of statements. F5, it will be seen by the shell that indicates if it has been closed. One more, if the command is successful, then execute statements. Else if, here you are not going to write the complete else if, elif, then write the command, then some set of statements. A final else, how many number of else if you can write? Final else, execute command. This fi indicates the if statement is completely closed. That is the last line of an if. We'll see one example now. Cat if example is there. Yes, I have written one program in this. I'll open that file itself. Directory OCT1 if example. Say this program, a simple program, grep command. I'll give the pattern from the command line, that is why $1 I have included. File name I have already included as sampleshell.sh. If I don't redirect the output to the dummy.txt, instead of showing the output, it will show the output of the grep command also. That is why I have redirected the output of the grep command to the dummy.txt. If this is successful, then what it is going to return? It will return 0 or 1. That exit status, if command is successful. If that is successful, then it will print the message pattern found or else pattern not found. The custom messages, pattern found, pattern not found. In that file, sampleshell.sh, echo statement is there, date statement is there. Now I will search the date inside that file. How to execute if example.sh, if example.sh, command line argument I have to send, date, pattern not found. Why the pattern is not found? Whether echo is found, pattern found. Whether this is found, THIS. Okay, whether it is in the double quotes. Okay. Whether hash is found. Yes, the hash is found. Whether CAL is found. Yes, calendar is found. The things which are there inside the double quotes, it is not going to search. All the other commands, CAL, echo, that it is going to, the pattern it is going to search. That is why, see, date it has not found, echo, this, ash, CAL, it has been found. See, whatever I enter here, this is called as a command line. This will be the $0, this will be the $1. If I send another input, that will be a $2. That $1, it will come here, it will be replaced. It will be replaced here, and that grep command, it is going to search that content in this file and it is going to redirect the output to the dummy.txt. If it is found, then the set of statements, echo statements, pattern found, else pattern not found. Fi indicates if has been closed, the complete if has been closed. In this way, one if and one else. You can write any number of elsif elif elif any number of elsif you can write. If you use it in that way, you can write your own software based on your requirement. With us it is same as like if and elif. One more expression that has been supported here is, say in this if it cannot compare two numbers, in this if it cannot compare the two numbers or two strings, that is not possible with the if statements. For that reason, if statements has some limitations. That is why we go for test statements. We use the word keyword test. The test statements that will evaluate to the true or false. The test statements is going to evaluate to true or false. That will compare two numbers, that will compare two strings, or a single value with a null value, or it will compare the file attributes. For that, they have given you the set of operators. EQ, NE, equal to, greater than, less than, less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, so many operators they have given. Remember, you have to remember this name, but these things you have to whenever you use, you have to start with the hyphen itself. Without the hyphen, if you write, it is meaningless. Hyphen UQ, hyphen NE, hyphen greater than or equal to, less than or equal to. How to write that? This is how. I'll assign some values, x equals 5, y equals 7, z equals 7.2. Assume that everyone has sent the attendance. This test statements, the test statements that we are going will discuss in the next class. Thank you for today. Those who have sent the attendance, you can exit.